Hello aspirants, looking at editorials in Question Bank for 10th November. The first editorial in the Hindu newspaper today is Understanding Trumpocalypse. So Trumpocalypse, this is regarding Donald Trump being elected as the president of USA. So this term comes from apocalypse. Apocalypse means what we call in Hindi as Kayamat, end of the world, means complete total destruction. So the editorial is talking about how polarizing this electoral campaign was. Polarizing means dividing, making things go poles apart. So the nation was divided on various issues because of some terms which were used, some comments which were made, issues like bigotry. So speaks of bigotry means intolerance. Patriarchy, male domination, racist rancor means racial hatred, which raised their ugly heads during these election campaign. It says it was a season of incivility. Incivility means rudeness. So all this was clearly visible during the election campaign. And now the apocalypse is that the climax is, or what the term it uses is apotheosis. So the apotheosis of this whole story, the climax, the end of this whole story is Mr. Trump's election. And it says this will not result into a welcome catharsis. Means catharsis means releasing of repressed emotions. People who were spoken up against, they wanted a catharsis now, that such viewpoints are rejected. But that has not taken place. Such viewpoints have actually been upheld and Trump has been elected as the president. So the reason for this being, the people who voted for him were people of the blue-collared group. So blue-collared workers. Blue-collared basically means people who are manual workers. So these are college dropouts, people who have not attended college, who enter into manual work, and they are the wage earners. And these people are separated from white collared workers who work in offices and cubicles. So they are well paid workers. So the blue collared workers actually feel that they have been deprived of the fruits of globalization. Globalization has adversely affected them. The rich have become richer and poor have become poorer. So what we want now is protectionism. Protectionism means protecting the people of the country, not letting globalization eat away on the resources of the country, on the benefits which can come to the people of the country. So not opening up the economy to the extent that it affects their own people. So this is what they expect from Donald Trump and the reason why they supported him too. So that is also clearly shown. It also gives some statistics. It says that according to the exit polls, 58% of the whites and 21% of non-whites voted for Mr. Trump. And of course, the remaining 37% of whites and 74% of non-whites voted for Hillary Clinton. Also, in men and women terms, more number of men voted for Trump than women. So that is also clear. Then it also speaks about how Trump's victory is same as Brexit, because that is also protectionism. What Brexit is also demanding is protectionism. EU becoming a super country, supranational. So that is like the national policies will also be decided by EU. So EU's policies have to be followed by all nations which are members of EU. So Britain now wanted itself to be independent, not having policies dictated by EU, not having to follow immigration norms that you have to accept immigrants, you have to allow foreign workers to work. So they wanted independence in that. So that also shows protectionism. The protectionist wave which is flowing through even Britain, the people's sentiments is towards that they do not want fruits of their own countries being deprived from them. So that is again the reason why Brexit also, which was not likely to happen but did take place. Donald Trump was not likely to win but did win. So understanding this is through this lens. So that is about it. And now right now it also says, as we saw in news also, that in his victory speech, Mr. Trump has appeared to quickly move past campaign recrimination, that what statements he made during then, he is not talking about that. There's a clear conciliatory tone. He's coming back to inclusiveness, that he's talking of all Americans will be taken together. He says, I will be the president of all Americans, irrespective of whether you voted for me or not. So this is the statement made by him in his victory speech. So that shows that he is going to be softer, but we'll have to wait and watch what actually happens in USA. Then the next editorial is a method in the shock therapy. So this is regarding the demonetization of the currency, which is trying to have unaccounted money, black money, coming back into the circulating economy. So for that, it is important that higher value currency notes are demonetized. So that results in money coming out, going into the banking system, so that this can be taken care of. But of course, this over a period of time will again result in things going back, because if you're talking of counterfeiting notes, again, when fresh currency comes in the market, though they have better security provisions, there are still over years, it will again be the case that counterfeiting may take place. So that threat will still be there. There'll be precautions required on those end. Then also awareness amongst the people too. And second aspect about black money. So again, when fresh notes are issued into the economy, over a period of time, people will again start stashing notes, currency. So again, black money will be generated. So it does not mean a complete end, but over a period of time, this issue will crop up again. But this is a one-time clearance, which will result in these effects being seen for a long period of time over the years. So that is true. So again, the editorial talks about how the Prime Minister justified the act of the government by saying how corrupt officials stash kilos of ill-gained cash under their mattresses, how illicit black money is fueling inflation as well as terrorism. So these emotions were evoked for implementing this initiative too. But then another aspect which has to be taken care of is that the poor should not suffer, because they will be the worst sufferers if there is not enough cash in their hands provided to them. Because then again, it requires that they should have bank accounts, they should be able to avail the banking system. So even the government had made arrangements for this, because this has been a well-planned initiative. First was introduced the Jan Dhan Yojana. So we saw the Jan Dhan Yojana, which targeted opening of bank accounts. So no frills accounts, bank accounts were opened. So that we saw, you can see here. This was Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. So the first state, it started in Jan 2015. So in the first phase, many bank accounts were opened. So it was also a debit card provided to the people who started this account. That was a RuPay debit card. Accident insurance cover was also provided along with this. A life insurance cover was provided additionally for people who registered them for this accounts before 26 Jan 2. So this, all these provisions were there. So Jan Dhan Yojana made sure that people had bank accounts. So that was the first step. Then after that, even an income tax declaration scheme came up. So this was in June 2016. So from 1st June 2016 to 30th September, that was a 4-month window given that you can declare your undeclared income. So that provision was also given. It was at a 45% rate that taxes would be collected. So this provision was also made that if you have undeclared income, undisclosed income, disclose it. So this was also there. Then another one was also for black money, foreign assets. So this was in 2015, that black money, undisclosed foreign income and assets can also be disclosed. So this was also, these two were amnesty schemes. Amnesty means that you pay the tax amount, you pay the penalty to, you pay the interest to, but there will be no prosecution against you. Your name will not be disclosed. So that was the protection given. So that these are called amnesty schemes. Schemes which protect the culprits. These are civilian violators that income tax has not been paid by them. So there will be no prosecution by the income tax department. So you are free from that fear, but declare. So that was there. So this also took place. And then eventually in November now, this was also successful. The income disclosure scheme has also been successful. It resulted in good collection and revelation of undisclosed income by people. Also, they called for extending the deadline, allowing them to pay in installments because they'll not be able to pay in a go. So also that was provided. So they have to pay in installments. So all these provisions have already been brought in place. So now the government struck by declaring that 500 and 1000 rupee notes will no longer be a legal tender. And yes, it is resulting in short-term difficulties presently, especially to the poor people. So the government has to make sure that people do not suffer in the course, but it is an essential step taken. There is a huge amount of black money, a parallel economy which is running in India. So we need to track that. So black money, what is black money? Black money does not mean money only through illegal activities like smuggling or other activities, criminal activities, but also money which you don't disclose is black money. So evasion of tax in any form is black money. That is, you are generating black money. The corruption activities, of course, corrupt activities are black money, because when you're paying money for some corruption, you're not going to disclose it in your income saying that this was used for this purpose. So all such undisclosed income, whether for criminal activities or just for stashing away, is resulting in generation of black money. So what is required is that the people disclose their entire income truthfully and pay the requisite taxation amount. So that is what it is targeting as well. So these are the various sources. So this is regarding the two editorials. Next we look at the question bank. Now in today's newspaper too, the lead article is again on Donald Trump. An article on the perspective page is also on Trump. One article is on life along the LOC. So that is regarding the cross-border tensions between India and Pakistan and how the civilians in that region are affected. So this we have discussed earlier, so we can skip this right now. One article which is of significance, on which we have framed a question, is on crop residue burning. So the question framed is, stubble burning is a common practice followed by farmers in the northern states in India. What are the reasons for the same? How can this practice be discouraged? So we have seen Delhi pollution levels have been rising presently, and the reason for this, one of the significant reasons, even by the estimates given by Ministry of Environment, it says that 20% of the pollution in Delhi is due to crop residue burning in the adjoining states. So how can this concern, why is this a concern, and how can this concern be eliminated? So crop residue burning is actually paddy stubble which is burned. So it is the paddy crop which has been cultivated by the farmers in northern India, especially in Punjab and Haryana. And this paddy is harvested, and after that the crop residue which stays on the farms is burnt. So this is done so that quickly the farms can be cleaned and then the next crop, which is the wheat crop, can be sown. So this is a practice which farmers indulge in during this time frame, during this winter, which results in pollution taking place, and farmers themselves are also aware, but they have no other alternative. So what are the reasons? We'll see one by one. The reason first one given is rice wheat rotation. So historically rice is not a crop which is sown in Punjab and Haryana majorly, but now over the years, with mechanization, with green revolution, new technology in place, mechanization of agriculture in place, there this has become possible, and farmers are sowing rice and wheat one after the other. So first rice is sown, and after that, once rice field is cleared, then wheat is sown. So this results in drastic reduction in the nutrients in the soil too. So it results in huge soil degradation, but this is the practice which they follow. Even experts say that farmers should indulge in crop diversification. So crop diversification means different types of crops sown. So some nutrients which are required by a particular type of plant are taken from the soil and some others returned. And when another crop is sown, that crop results in some other form of nutrients taken and given back. So that results in soil fertility maintained. But that is not possible through rice wheat rotation. So crop diversification, they encourage cultivation of vegetables and fruits. But of course, that has not taken place in Punjab, Haryana, because rice wheat cultivation is much more economically viable. So that is there. Irrigation is extensively developed in Punjab, Haryana. So all this is there. Minimum support prices are provided for rice and wheat. There is a huge market for this commodity. There is government procurement, so secured market as well. So why would the farmers not indulge in this? So there is policy which favors this. So they indulge in this rice wheat rotation. Then the second aspect is that the crop which they sow, the seeds which they sow, are of high yield varieties. So these high yield varieties result in much more production. So multiple times production is possible, but then it also results in huge amount of residue generated. So that is also a concern. Then the next reason is use of crop harvesters. So the farmers here, they use combined harvesters to harvest their fields. So the reason here being that labor is not available in sufficient amount during the harvesting time, and also labor costs are high. And since these fields have already been mechanized, they prefer using mechanized machines, that is combined harvesters, which are used to harvest the crop. Now with the use of these combined harvesters, the problem is that in harvesting the crop, the residue which stays back, that is the crop stubble, is such that it cannot be later removed manually too. So it becomes difficult to remove manually, and then the best way which is present to the farmers then is to burn this crop residue. So that is the problem. And finally, the last reason is that rice straw is of little economic value, and this is of most significance, because if you see, wheat stubble also stays because combine harvester is used for harvesting wheat also. So there also the same problems prevails that we cover crop stubble will remain on the field. But then in that case, the farmers use a chaff combine, a reaper, which removes even this stubble from the field. So and then this stubble is used, processed and used as a feed for animals. So it has a market, it is sold off too. So that is the reason why this is used. That is the bhusa. So but then with respect to rice, that is not the case, because rice residue is not palatable to the animals, and it is because it has high silica content too. So that is the reason why it has no economic value in the same sense as wheat. So that is the reason why they will not incur costs on harvesting or removing this crop stubble through using mechanization. The cheapest and the quickest way then is to burn the residue. So that is what they indulge in. So to find a solution to this, what is of significance is this last point, that rice straw is of little economic value. So if we can find some economic significance for rice residue, then it can also be fruitfully used, harvested and fruitfully used. So the first application is that can be used in biomass, as a biomass in biogas plants, and electricity can be generated. Then second, it can be used in soil, so it can help in retaining soil moisture. It can also be used as an organic manure. Then third application is it can be used in cardboard making and in packing industry too. Then fourth application is that it can be used to extract yeast protein. So there is more scientific research required on this aspect too. And finally, it can also result in reducing the lower economic significance rice straw being generated. That means research being done on developing not just high yield variety rice, but also high yield variety rice which has high quality straw also. So this also requires research. So these will result in this crop residue issue being eliminated. So that is it for today. You can download the PDF file from the website. The description provides the link address for this website too.